Hello, my artists. So today we're going to look at gesture drawings. And this really is an underdrawing or the first step to drawing a person or a body. So cartoon artists or comic strip artists, illustrators that draw comic books, characters like Batman, the Avengers, they all start with a gesture drawing, okay? And this mannequin here is my little friend. Artists use these to pose, in any pose, an action pose that shows movement, right? Maybe this person's running. Okay, we use this to then draw the basic shapes of the body. We start with the head first, then the torso, which is the center of the body, and then the arms, okay? It's much simpler to draw a person if you break down those shapes to those geometric shapes, okay? So we're going to practice a little gesture drawing showing movement, using our mannequin friend here. All you will need is a piece of paper, something to draw with, and we will use our little mannequin friend. I'll put him in some poses and we'll try to draw him, okay? So first I will take my paper and we'll do four different gestures, okay? So I will fold my paper in half first. Boop. Fold it again. Boop. Boop. And then open it up. So I have four different squares, and we'll draw a gesture inside each square, okay? So let's start with this original pose. And this is our mannequin running. So as I draw, I'm going to draw him in just one square. And I want to start with this head, which is an oval shape. And I'm drawing really loosely. I'm not worried about erasing or adding details. It's just a little oval. And next, let's draw this shape, which is an oval, another oval. It's just a little larger. Okay. Okay, and you can stop the video at any time and take your time drawing my mannequin friend here for your gesture drawing. It's taking you a little longer. If we need to keep going, keep going. The next shape now, let's start breaking down these legs and arms into ovals. So I have one oval here. We'll draw this oval. And it's a long, thin oval, longer than the head. And then another oval here. And a small, little oval for those hands, okay? And notice this mannequin, he doesn't have a lot of details. We don't have any fingers here, any hair, any nose, any facial features. The eyes and the nose are not there. This is something you're going to add in later when you add those details. We're focusing on the movement, showing, running, jumping. So let's keep breaking down those shapes. Right? And if you go past your little square, that's okay. So I have now my ovals, my arms, and I can see now, I can see part of this arm, right here, this back arm, it's overlapped. I'm gonna place that right there. What's next? We have the legs. Let's create another oval here. That bent leg. Okay, I have an oval here. Let's break it down again, going this way. I'm drawing this oval now, and I won't forget that little foot, which is just another oval, okay? And right now my arms are really long, they're not as long as my legs, and that's okay. This is a gesture drawing. Next, let's draw this back leg coming out. Let me show this movement. So even though I don't have any details to this gesture drawing, I can tell that he's running or jumping. Okay, I've captured that movement. That's what we want to do. We're going to come back in with those details. Let's go ahead and see another pose. Okay, our friend has changed poses here. So now we have less movement, right? The hands are on the hips. We'll still start with the head, which is an oval, but now it's tilted a little bit, right? This head is tilted a little. So I'll pick any other empty square. And I'll begin my gesture drawing. So I have an angled little oval. And next, we want this large oval here. Now in my first gesture drawing, I drew just one large oval. If you want an extra challenge, you can draw each individual circle. So instead of creating one giant oval, because we can break down the body into lots of little geometric shapes, lots of circles, ovals, even squares, you can add a circle here, another smaller circle for that waist, and a bigger circle for those hips, okay? All right, so I'll go ahead and add one's getting a little larger. If I added these separate circles and ovals, he'll start turning in to these. Now this guy, he's a little taller. He starts coming into this square at the bottom. And that's okay, I'm gonna leave that. This is my gesture drawing. This is how artists decide what pose they want. We'll choose one of these poses and create an action pose showing movement with it, okay? So let's go ahead and see what pose is next. Okay, we have our next pose, and this leg is pushing forward. It's either a kick or a dance. Maybe he's dancing. And again, we'll start here with the head. Draw that head first. Followed by that chest, which looks like an oval. Our arms and legs are next. Now, this is a rather challenging pose for the arms, because one arm is covering part of the other arm. It's overlapping, so you won't see that. Okay. So what you're going to draw is, as you draw this one, it's okay to put that oval right over top where you would see it. Right? Even though you know they're overlapping, this is our underdrawing, it's our gesture. We just want to show that movement, so don't worry if you can see the overlapped arm. If you can see it through the other one, that's okay. We're drawing with our pencil. Remember, we have to make those mistakes. Underneath all drawings, you have your gesture drawings, your under drawings. Just keep going, okay? Just keep going. We will keep drawing these circles, this leg. Okay, Okay, until we have movement. It looks like he's kicking. I'll make mine a little darker so we can see my lines. Can't really see my lines very well. Gesture. And as you draw this out and pose these, when you choose which pose you like best for your drawing, you could also take your foil, like when we created forms, all right, and create an actual pose with your foil, okay? You can always turn these drawings into a sculpture. Remember, drawing is the start of all artwork. All artwork starts with a drawing. All right, let's see one more pose, okay? Okay, so this is very challenging because we can't see his back leg at all, right? I can tell that it's bent, and when you look at it, you know that it's bent, but when you draw that, you won't show that leg at all. Maybe if it was angled like this, we'll see a little bit of the foot, but that's our perspective. When we're looking straight forward at him, we can't see the back leg, okay? So when you're drawing this part, only going to have, whoops, sorry, an oval shape here, okay? Just an oval shape. So let's go ahead and start again with the head. Breaking down those shapes. I have an oval here, little circle, whoops, and I keep trying to knock him down. Just very loosely drawing. That means lightly. Your pencil's moving a lot. You're not worried about perfect lines. Okay, if you have someone at home with you that you can pose for you, you can try this. Not only with our mannequin friend, but with someone at home. Mom, dad, brothers, sisters. Breaking down those arms and legs. So from my arms here, right, just like this, I'm breaking down these ovals. This oval's going across more horizontally, and this oval's coming up, oop, vertically. Okay. And really just give yourself a few minutes to draw these gestures. You can always pause the video, but don't take too much time focusing on those details. You don't want too many details in a gesture drawing. Once we have our poses to choose from, we're going to add some things on top. So there's one of two things we can do, okay? I can either, oops, I was looking for my other paper. Oop, I'll move my little friend aside. I can either draw right on top of these papers, of these gestures, creating an idea of what's going on. So to me, this guy looks like maybe he's running. This pose, this movement looks like he's dancing. Here maybe we're dancing. So what I'm going to do is add some details on top of these gesture drawings, okay? And this is how illustrators and artists begin. And I'm gonna zoom in, I'll just do a couple so you can see my lines, because I don't know how well this, you can see this. So I'll start with this guy, maybe he's running. Oh, maybe he's a superhero. So I'll add a little triangle, nose, and just start adding some details. Hi. He's smiling. We'll just have some ideas here. Maybe there's a long cape. If he's a superhero. And I can start adding clothes right on top. Darkening my lines. Maybe he has a mask on because he's a superhero. You can just start adding darker lines around. Around our gesture drawing, really building those up. And I'm adding lines here for little Boots. He's a superhero. And you can add as many details as you want, showing that movement. You can add color in. Let's see for this gesture. Just going over, and I'm not erasing. I'm not worried about that. I'm just going around. Maybe, you know what, I might make this a big dress. Maybe she's wearing a really big dress. Maybe we don't have a lot of movement here. I can add big dress. It's all the way down to her feet. And now since I can still see her legs, that's where we would want to come in, because we drew lightly and just erase the legs. If that's what artists do. You have your guidelines first, your gesture drawings, and then we can add those details. All right. Oh, you know what? I'm going to give her bangs like mine. Some hair, maybe. This is me. Okay, we can add lots of details to these gestures. So all I did was take these existing gesture drawings showing that movement and started adding some details to them. Okay? And I didn't finish my arms here, but that's okay. If you wanted to copy one of your gestures or keep these as a reference so you can look at them anytime you want to create movement in the body, you can always draw on a separate piece of paper and create a whole picture just using these gestures, okay? And these can be a lot of fun. Don't spend too much time on one gesture. Remember, they're fast. They're fast. We're drawing lightly, breaking that body down into shapes, okay? You can draw anything if you break down those lines and shapes, okay? Okay, my artist. And don't forget, if you have foil at home, Play-Doh at home, use your gesture drawings to create some sculptures, right? Turn those flat shapes into 3D forms. Okay, my artist, I will see you soon in person or on Zoom. Have a great day. Bye.